So then, how do I pray? And what do I pray? Well, in my last video, Only Praying is Praying, I talked about how talking about praying, well, that's not praying. Talking about scriptures, well, that's not praying. Only praying is actually praying. And that I suspect that this is the one thing that we as Christians are doing too little of. So, okay, we're all in agreement. We need to be praying more. And I would think we all want to be praying more. But what I find with my coaching clients and people in general is that they really don't know what to pray. Well, you and I know that the greatest thing we could ever pray is the Word of God back to the King himself who created the Word. So, you know, the first place that we always begin is with the Word of God, right? You know, when you find a scripture, you can pray this back to the Lord. Now, here's a great one. I just opened the Bible, right? And I happen to fall on Romans 8:11. And the scripture says, "And if the Spirit of the one who raises Jesus from the dead dwells in you, then he who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies through his Spirit who indwells you." Can I turn that into a prayer? Absolutely. Can I put somebody that I'm praying for, their name into that? Absolutely. Could I begin to pray, "Lord, may the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwell in," and then put in that person's name. "That one who raised Jesus from the dead, Lord, may they have their life lifted up through the Spirit and indwelling them." See, we can take the Word of God and we can apply it in our prayer. Well, you know, there's also ways to do that through some books that help you to do prayers. This is one of my favorite books. I have used this book for years. It's called The Weapons of Our Warfare, and it is written by an incredible man called Kenneth Scott. And I've ordered lots of books. You can go online, you can find him. I even had the opportunity to speak to him one day while I was calling to order some books. Here's the thing. This book is divided up with scriptures, whether you want to pray for healing, whether you want to pray about singleness, whether you want to pray about having more praise and worship in your life, it's broken down into different areas. And so imagine when you're limited on time and maybe limited on understanding of how to pray, you could turn to an incredible book like this, which is very helpful. This particular part is called Victory Over Sin, Strongholds, and Addictions. And let me give you just a little taste of how praying the Word of God is so powerful. "When I become weak through Christ, I am made strong. God's grace is sufficient for me. For when I am weak in myself, I am strengthened in him. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me and in me. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is strength and liberty." Now, I just prayed three scriptures right out of the Word of God. And here's the thing that I love to share with people and I love to remind myself. Do you realize that the angels of the Lord are always on assignment to bring the Word of God to pass? Yes. See, angels are messengers of God and they are working for those who are obtaining salvation. What that means is when you became a child of God, isn't this wonderfully crazy? That you actually were given the ability to not only pray, but to be confident that there is an angel, at least, who is working to bring about the Word of God for your life, especially as you're praying the Word of God. The angels of the Lord are very zealous for God's word, and they love to bring the Word of God to pass. So when we lift up the Word of God to heaven, we can be confident angels are bringing the Word of God to pass in God's fullness of time, in God's way, absolutely. We don't direct the Lord. You know, I think that there can be this misconception in our zealousness to just pray anything. Well, we always, always, always want to leave room for the will of God and the ways of God and the timing of God. Jesus talked about that, right? Let your kingdom come, O Lord. Let your will be done, O God. So what I've learned over these many, many years of praying, and I'm still growing in this for sure, is that it's always okay to pour out my heart before the Lord and ask him for the thing I'm desiring. However, it is always, always, always important to pray, but nevertheless, Lord, let your will be accomplished in my life. You know, many years ago, I was in a prayer meeting and there was a man who prayed that, you know, Lord, let your will be done. And the Holy Spirit reminded me very gently, and I want to remind you, is that when Jesus prayed that in the garden, when he said, Lord, please let this cup pass from me. See, he was pouring out his heart to his Father. He said, Lord, please take this cup from me, but nevertheless, not my will, but let your will be done. That is such a sacred prayer. But what the Holy Spirit whispered to me that I had never, ever seen before, and I want to whisper it very beautifully and gently to you, is that Jesus knew what it would be if the Lord didn't take that cup from him. See, Jesus knew the prophecy. He knew what was coming. That was the greatest act of worship, to say to the Father, nevertheless, let your will be done. I say this because when we pray that prayer, I want us to pray it very soberly. You know, sometimes the way that God wants to answer a prayer for someone's life, it might be that there's going to be something in our life that God wants to use. There might be something that causes our life to shake in order for that prayer to come to pass. But here's what you and I can be confident in. Whatever the Lord allows in the life of one of his children, it is always for our good. Doesn't always feel good in the moment, but it always is worked for our good. So that's why we can absolutely trust that when we pray our prayers, but then say, Lord, but nevertheless, let your will be done, we can be confident that whatever he's going to use to bring his will to pass, it will be for his glory and it will be for our good. So I just want to encourage you today, don't direct God. Amen. We are his people. He is our king, but he has given us this amazing ability to pray, to be heard, and to have our prayers answered. The best way we can pray is the word of God. And if you are not yet comfortable with that, then absolutely, there are so many books that are available. This just happens to be my favorite. And I don't know, maybe it will be your favorite too. So let's get to praying, because only praying is praying, not talking about praying, but literally praying. And let's pray the most effectively, and that is to pray the word of the Lord back to the Lord, and be confident that through the power of the Holy Spirit and by the help of angels, taking that word, that eternal word, and working to bring it to pass, that we will see, whether it's this side of heaven or on that side of heaven, the answered prayers of the things that we prayed. Now you go out there and have a prayerful day, and I pray that it's a day full of peace and love. God bless you.